In the last video, I showed you that beech bark is a fantastic alternative to birch bark as fire starter. In this video, I will test other types of barks from which I suspect that they burn. So let's try out if you can use them as fire starter too. Stay tuned. Hello YouTube! Welcome to another video on my Swiss Army Knife channel. Birch bark is a very popular natural fire starter. The combustible betulin in its bark helps against fungal attack, sunburn, it dries the decomposing resistance and it makes the bark waterproof. Other trees struggle with the exactly same problems. That's why my thesis is other trees should have the same or similar substances in the bark. Today I would like to prove my thesis. I will show you other types of bark you can potentially use as fire starter. But that another type of bark became relevant as bushcraft fire starter, it must be possible that you can harvest it easy and in a sufficient amount. In my experience, the available quantity of a fire starter material is often the problem, because the initial flame has to burn at least a couple minutes that he can set in flame the rest. In my last video I learned that it's only the ultimate outside layer, the bark layer of some types of trees you can use as fire starter. But to harvest this bark without the cambium and bast layer inside is often the hard task. Cutting off a piece of bark to scrap off the bast and cambium layer with a blade is not efficient. In the most cases the bark is not stable enough and tears apart. If the bark have several layers, like birch or cherry, you can often pull on a protruding piece of bark and pull off a strip. Depending on how much bark you pull away, it can injure the tree. Stripping off the bark from a rotten branch or rotten trunk is better in any case and should be the major way to do it. Harvesting the bark layer like this is easy and quick and for sure the most gentle harvesting option for the tree. The bark layer is often the last thing that decomposes when a branch or a trunk rots, especially when oils and resin are stored in. In my opinion, this is the most promising approach for harvesting enough material that you can start a fire. To make sure that I have the best possible support for this project and to make sure that I don't confuse the tree sorts, I involve my friend Ben. Ben is a forest scientist and he knows almost everything about trees and plants. Ben and I spent a whole day in the forest for filming these tests. But it was a dry period. To make sure that these barks I will show you also works in wet condition, I repeated the tests as snowfall and rain set in some days later. At the same time as this video, Ben will upload a video on his channel in German and in English where he explained the exact reason why these different types of bark are burning or not, but with a lot more scientific background than me. So I'm sure this will be a super interesting video. The link to this video you find here, in the description box below and in the end card. So let's start with our tests. First of all, I want to give you a feedback to the beech bark video from last week. In this video, I dipped beech bark 10 seconds into water. With that, I wanted to simulate wet bark. In the last 2 days, it was raining and snowing here in Switzerland, and I realized that the bark was more soaked as after dipping dry bark for 10 seconds into water. To be honest, I had more problems to ignite the wet bark. But, as you can see, it still worked. In my opinion, the combustibility of wet beech bark is not as good as wet birch bark, but it's still amazing. If you wanna have more information about beech bark as fire starter material, please watch my video from last week. The link you find in the info card and in the description box below. Some of you will already know that cherry bark can be used as fire starter. There are already some videos on YouTube about this topic. Whenever I tried to pull off a piece of protruding bark, the wound I caused was pretty deep. I was never able to peel off just a fine layer like I noticed from birch bark. Therefore, I recommend to harvest the bark from a rotten branch. That takes definitely more care on the tree. Scraps of dust or fine cutted bark can even be ignited with a fire steel. Cherry bark doesn't burn quite as well as birch bark, but it's still one of the best natural tinders I know. Here in Switzerland, hazel is a very common plant. It grows almost everywhere. It would be a real game changer if hazel bark would burn that well that you can use it as fire starter. And exactly this was the reason why I started to make burning tests with hazel. Hazel bark is so thin that it took me extreme care to scrape off the best and cambium layer. With this technique, you will never get enough bark that you can use it as fire starter. But at least I was able to provide the proof that hazel bark indeed have some potential as fire starter. At the place where I harvest the hazel branches for my carving workshops, I realized that there are many badly rotted hazel branches lying on the ground. At some branches, the bark flaked off during the rotting process. In the past, I never ever had the idea that this wet stuff could burn. But in the context of these burning tests, I held my lighter under every material, no matter how hopeless. I would say, make your own opinion if hazel bark just burns like normal wood or if there must be some fire accelerating substances inside. In this test, I compare the burning time of hazel bark with newspaper. And here I try to ignite hazel bark with my fire steel. After these tests, it's hard to believe to me that hazel doesn't work as fire starter. Please try it out and give me your feedback. Holly has been always a pretty boring plant with annoying prickly leaves to me. I have never heard of a specific property of this plant that would be useful in a bushcraft context. In addition, this plant is protected in many European countries, although it is very common, at least in my area. Again, a carefully removed best and cambium layer. What I saw next blew my socks off. Can you see this black smoke? Not far from the last spot, I found a rotten piece of a holy trunk. Look how crazy this wet piece of bark is burning. In my opinion, holy is definitely a fire starter secret. But keep in mind that this plant is protected in many European countries. The next bark I would like to introduce is the pine bark. I wasn't sure if I should thematize it because all other barks are from deciduous trees. But maybe it's valuable having this trick in your mental toolbox. The color and the structure of the bark changes as higher you look up the trunk. The lower half is mostly brown and barky. The upper half is mostly lighter and smoother. In the upper part of the trunk you can often discover many paper-like bark scraps. In this scene I'm harvesting these bark scraps from a fallen pine tree. These super thin protruding scales burn very well, but they also have a short burning time. To be honest, I have no idea if these scales have resin inside or not, but I know that the tree has to be lying on the ground that you can harvesting it. The reason why I want to test alder bark for its combustibility is that alder is closely related to birch. Unfortunately, I couldn't find a rotted alder where I could harvest a lot of bark. So the only way to test this bark was to cut off a piece of bark. After that, I removed bark and best layer very carefully. The combustibility performance of this little piece of bark was quite impressive. Together with Ben, I tried to pull off a few small protruding pieces of bark. But we weren't really successful. But
the small pieces we could win burned very well. So I dare to say that alder bark would be a good fire starter. Let me know if any one of you found out more about it. European buckthorn and blackthorn was the last trees I tested for the combustibility of the bark. Also with these trees I had the problem that I didn't find the rotted one. In this scene I tested the European blackthorn. I can tell you the burning performance of both barks was promising.
So my friends, let me tell you some last words to this video. The content of this video is just based on a few tests we made right now. Please keep in mind, this is not scientifically proven. I'm sure there are still a lot of other tree barks with well-burning bark. So be open, be curious, try out, and I'm super happy about every feedback I get from you. So my friends, that's it for today. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to visit Ben's channel. And see you next Friday. Ciao!